In this video, I'm going to show you how to utilize the power of Unreal 5's new modeling mode and the different tools that come with it. So first of all, click on box over here, then click on cube grid. This is going to generate a grid around the world. You can then do things like this, hit Q and E to bring up your new blocks. Keep pressing E to raise it a little bit higher. And when you're happy with it, just let go. If you want to add more things to this, for example, I want to add a little space here in the middle, like a pool. So I'm going to highlight all this area and then press Q. Make it smaller. There we go. Now, let's say you wanted to add a texture to this section. That's different to this section. Then we can go down. We have to press complete first so that it creates the static mesh. This is now going to add the static mesh to your generated mesh folder, wherever you set it. You can also set it to be somewhere else based on the settings down here. So anyway, we click on this mesh now. We're going to click on material editor. And now we can click over here on the selection mode. We're going to click all with an angle so that we can select just this area. And that's going to select this area that we set down here. And we're going to add another component to this material array. We're going to do world yellow in our case, there. And then we're going to set the active material to be this world yellow. And then we'll click assign active material. So now this section here has that material, whereas this section up here has this first material. So let's do local green. Do I have a local green? Yes, I do. There we go. We click accept. So now that it's created this mesh, we can click on it and see in the details panel that we have this new static mesh created. This is our mesh. You see it's got two material slots, and they encompass the areas that we set. So we can do some more stuff here. So if we isolate our mesh and look at its UVs, we can see that it's got too many. So we can click on that mesh again, go over here to our mesh ops, and click on simplify. And we can set it to simplify the minimal shape preserving. So that's going to preserve the shape of our shape and minimize the number of UVs. So now that we've done that, as you can see, it's got a lot less UVs. So that's already optimized a little bit. We can also go further with that. If we have the situation where our mesh renders the textures a little bit weird, in this case it doesn't, but if it did, you go to UVs and you can click project, and then you could lower the dimensionality to 100. And then once you set that, then that would be a lot more optimized. If we go back to our mesh, our original static mesh, we can see over here that it's got less triangles and less vertices than it did before. It's literally that simple. That's it for this quick tutorial, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.